The invisible enemy. I think that I shall never see the world evolve as fast as it can be. A world of stress and working like crazy has temporarily been halted by an invisible enemy. A micro-enemy that none of us has ever suspected, to bring down great nations and the global economy. Where jobs, finances, basic needs like food and shelter, has now become so gloomy for many. As for me, staying home hasn't been a tragedy, as I was forced to mingle and interact with my family. Cooking home-cooked meal instead of eating fast food, biking with my kids, and playing board games has alleviated my anonymity. My kids are now learning new ways of doing things, like Google Classroom and dancing lessons through Zoom maybe. And these, perhaps, will become the new norm of our new society. As Mother Nature forces us to evolve with modern-day technology, we have to adjust and do most of the typical things we do remotely. The world may never be the same, after COVID-19 and our plight to become germ-free. As we pause and fight the battle against this invisible enemy, it made me think and ponder that maybe no amount of Harvard education can eliminate this virus completely. But that sounds silly, as a doomsday prophecy. Who knows? But maybe Dr. Charles Lieber possesses the pandemic key to unlock the world against this sad reality. How to use education a force for good is the theme of this poetry. It is just a pity to hear that a professor from the prestigious Harvard University to be implicated in such scrutiny. Locked up in jail, he cannot be subservient to the community. We need to act collectively, as this is the greatest attribute of the human species. Had Trump coalesced with Xi Jinping to form a scientific army, and together, they could have built a vaccine that could have prevented a lot of mortality. As a call to action to humanity. For now, let us not hold hands nor visit our grandparents, and please, take all the precautions seriously. Since COVID-19 is not your regular flu, older people and those with pre-existing medical conditions are most likely to subdue. Be aware and cognizant on how not to spread this virus, as this is the best you can do. Some says that methylene blue has been proven effective against SARS-CoV-2. The one you take when you have urinary tract infection, that makes your pee color blue. At least, that's what the Chinese doctor said, and you can Google it too. Others insist that you can get yourself some sun and UVC too. Since coronaviruses hate alkaline, acids, and the heat too. But hey, UVC can burn your eyes and can cause skin cancer too. I guess if this pandemic doesn't kill you, it will most likely evolve you. It is ironic that collective cooperation amidst social separation is all we needed to do to combat SARS-CoV-2. But it seems that caring for others despite their color, race, and culture is something hard for all of us to do. Had the US helped China at the peak of their crisis, they could have reciprocated the favor too. Based on what we learned from this pandemonium, viruses can cross continental boundaries in only a day or two. Now Japan is providing Avigan, something that supposedly cures the COVID-19 flu. Maybe that's what the superpowers should have done, in order to protect me and you. As a final thought, that I would like to ask to all of you. Is COVID-19 the invisible enemy, or maybe it was you? Perhaps this is Mother Nature's way to heal the world around you. Because maybe the invisible enemy is you.